We back, baby. All right, guys, no special intro today. I'm at the Dragon's Lair right now. I'm about to go hit a little shoulders and arms. This is the first time I've hit shoulders and arms like by themselves for a while. Probably since I was back in Washington running the Arnold split. But I've been kind of tweaking the way I've been working out recently. And I'm running an Arnold split pretty much with a little tweaks here and there. But I got shoulders and arms today. That's all that matters. And I thought it'd been a while since I actually took you guys through a workout. So we'll slow it down. I'll take you through each exercise, and then we're gonna cash out, because this video is gonna be about what a typical rest day looks like for me. So you guys are getting a little bit of everything. You're gonna get a shoulder workout, an arm workout today. You get to see what my rest day looks like, because you need to be doing certain things to optimize like recovery on your rest days. Just little things, bro. I'm not a fucking scientist over here, but like I know the basic stuff that you should be doing on rest days. So we're gonna look at that. And yeah, what else? Dallas, anything else crazy?
For the van?
Dallas got a membership.
Dallas
ping pong? Dallas got a membership at the Dragon's Lair. He's with the big dogs now.
Hell yeah.
Fucking Dallas is in there all trend up.
Fuck out my way, boy.
Yeah, Dallas runs that shit, bro. I'm more scared of Dallas than I am of anyone else in that gym. Oh, I'm about to smack this fucking mode, baby. Such a thick concoction. I had nitric, two scoops of nitric, two scoops of energy, and some glycerol. I'm going two scoops of energy today because I'm kind of tired. I slept really good. I just been going hard the last couple of days, but I have a rest day tomorrow, so I'm gonna go in, I'm gonna finish it. And also, I guess this is gonna be a full day eating video too. Like I'm gonna break down my food as well, because a lot of you guys have been asking me about bulking tips and shit, but I'm not, like I said in a few videos ago, like I'm not bulking anymore, bro. I'm like chilling. I'm in like a slight cut, honestly. I was gonna say I'm in maintenance calories, but I'm in a little bit of a cut, just a 300 calorie deficit, nothing crazy. I've been doing that for like a week and a half, 2 weeks. Cause bro, like I said, I just wanna feel really good. My back's been feeling a lot better. And I just know if I drop weight and keep stretching and keep working on my mobility and my recovery and whatnot, then I just know I'm gonna feel a lot better. So that's the goal, is to feel real good right now. So the goal weight I have in mind is like 220. I wanna get down to 220, and then I'll just chill there. Maybe main gain, fluctuate from 220, 225. I don't wanna get any heavier than that, bro. Like, it's not really what I'm looking for. I more just wanna be fucking healthy and have a sick physique, you feel me? I'm not going men's open, I'm sorry. Gorilla Mind's running its Black Friday sale. It's still going on. My code's a little bit different though. It's, what is it? It's B2G1 Big Dog. Buy two, get one Big Dog. That's gonna be my code all week for Gorilla Mode. They're running different sales each week. I'll be plugging them on my Instagram if you wanna go check it out. But if not, just hit me up on either like Instagram or ask me in the comments below like what the deals are. Maybe I'll put it in like the description of this video, because they're running different sales each week. But enough of all that shit. Let's go fucking lift.
Everyone's on Rice Krispies nowadays. This isn't like a new thing. Everyone's like, oh, bro, you got me on Rice Krispies, dog. Bro, that's been around, bro. Homie got a nosebleed.
Damn.
I've never gotten a nosebleed from lifting.
How do you get one? You just fucking push like, too hard and just fucking...
Usually on deadlifts, dudes get nosebleeds and they go mad heavy. I used to go heavy, too, like in the Marine Corps, bro.
Yeah.
Those are the good old days.
Back in the wrong
before
days.
I took an arrow to my fucking spine, bro.
Bounce World. Retell it.
Bouncing Trampoline World. Bro, long story short, like 2 years ago, I got scorpion at a trampoline park. I got scorpion, bro, like bad, bro. And like, dude, I think ever since then, my back has just not been the same. It always hurts. I always gotta be stretching and working, rolling out, which is good because I stay on top of it. But bro, like, just for a back update, because a lot of you guys asked me about my back. Sorry if I'm yelling, it's super loud in here, but the back's doing better. I've been stretching. We got the inversion table.
Hell yeah.
I'm dropping weight. I'm coming back, baby. I'll be squatting again one day. But honestly, my leg days have been going off. I've been doing a lot of split squats. I've been just living and dying by split squats. By the time this back shit's over, I'm going to be fucking split squatting 150s.
Jesus. Two Rice Krispies? What you hit?
Why do you call me? I'm doing one of Sweet Dog's back workouts. I'm about to get her app and start doing her workouts for spring.
All right, so we're starting with just dumbbell shoulder press today, nothing crazy. I'm gonna do four sets of 10 to 12. Hopefully I might have to drop weight. I'm at 75s right now, but just go up, come down slow. I'm focusing on coming down a little bit slower on the descent, okay? I've been rushing it a little bit too much, so make sure you're not just going in there and cranking that shit out. Okay, you gotta have control. That's where you get that mind-muscle connection. So that's what the goal is for this one. Probably not gonna do anything too crazy for shoulders. I'll start with three shoulder exercises, one main like more compound like lift like the dumbbell, and then I'm gonna hit my delts, my rear delts, and my the front side of my shoulder as well with the lateral raises and the top head of shoulder. Sorry, I'm out of breath. And then I'm gonna bounce over to arms. Okay, I think I'm gonna finish off in the very end after I hit triceps and biceps. I'm gonna come back to shoulders just on the seated machine press and like do three burnout sets just to finish off shoulders. But let's jump to these lateral raises. You ain't ready for the evil and the spark that will set the dog off, making the angels fucking scoff. From the heavens up above, gotta be up in the stuff. Films, they the victims, torch on with the cuffs locked tight on the wrist. With the sight, I cannot miss. Raphael gon' take a lot and murder a dumb bitch. Yeah, I'm always ready, always, always ready to go kill. Like a lurker from the ground, shooting spikes, making kills. And the paling for the thrill, smash the skulls to mush. Then after I'm done, I'm pounding on your girl's tush. Lost 2 pounds after that one. All right, so that was a little shoulder and arm routine. Pretty good pump. I felt pretty solid about it when it's all said and done. No, I was pretty tired at the end, but go ahead and run that workout. Let me know what you think in the comments. And if you guys want, I could try and start putting more workouts, I guess breaking down and taking you through my complete workouts more often. I used to do that a little bit more, but I hope you enjoyed it. I'm gonna go home, I'm gonna smack some food, and then tomorrow, I'm gonna wake up and I'm gonna run you through a full day of eating for me right now. My rest day, like regimen, like what I do throughout my rest days, I guess my rest day protocol. And we'll see what else happens. That's about it, boys. P-Way the only way. See you in the morning. All right, what's up, guys? Hey, it's the following morning. I got some sleep. I'm waking up. Today's a rest day. And like I was mentioning earlier, I'm going to take you through my whole rest day protocols, show you some of the stuff that I do on my rest days so that I guess I could help aid in my recovery process. You know, you don't want to just sit around on your rest days. That's probably the worst thing you can do. You just want to be a little active, make sure that you take the time to stretch a little bit and little other things that could help your body recover a little bit better so that we could train harder the next time we go to the gym. I'm also going to walk you through what a day of eating looks like for me right now. It's not that exciting. I'm sitting at like 2,900 calories, just below maintenance, because I want to drop a little bit of weight slowly. I'm trying to hold on to as much muscle as I can while I also drop a little bit of weight, tighten things up, you know, feel good. I'm just trying to feel good at this point. But yeah, we're about to go make breakfast real quick. I'll show you what my first meal of the day looks like. And then we're gonna go ahead and jump right into the recovery activities for our rest day. So let's get into it.
Dope shit like that, Germ. Oh, hi. Welcome back to Kids. Follow your dreams. Yeah. Wanna get a mansion, a jacuzzi, a theater to watch my movies, couple whips and lots of fancy things. The kids, they call it Goonies. I see the future, crystal ball, mirror, mirror hanging on the wall.
Alright, so this is what the first meal is looking like. It's nothing too crazy, boys. Just one cup of egg whites, two whole eggs, a little bit of a side salad, 1.5 servings of cream of rice, a little bit of sugar-free syrup, and some cinnamon. And of course, I'm gonna smack my vitamins.
All right, so I'm gonna smack that. I'll let it digest a little bit. I have some stuff I have to do on the computer anyways. And then we'll go ahead and get into the more active portion of my rest day, i.e. cardio and stretching and whatnot. So I'll take you along for that, show you what's good. I'm not gonna go through my whole mobility routine, but just the basic idea. You guys are always asking me for my mobility routine, and guys, I am not like a yoga instructor, bro. I do very basic stretches. Just try to stay loose to the best of my ability, but that's the name of the game, baby. Staying loose, staying healthy. I'm all about longevity, and if you want to be lifting for a long time, if you want to be active for a long time throughout your life, bro, you have to take stretching and mobility and recovery seriously. There's no way around it, because eventually, like, I know that when I was younger, bro, you think that you're invincible and you're gonna go forever, but bro, I'm telling you right now, I'm 26 and I do not feel the same that I did when I was 22. You're gonna, especially with lifting, bro, that you're gonna have aches and pains, and it's gonna wear you down over time. So just please, for me, take stretching and mobility seriously. It's not as cool as fucking deadlifting 500 pounds or whatever, but it's important, almost more so important. So we're gonna get into that today.
Damn, Kat, your breakfast looks pretty good too. Show us what you got.
Turkey bacon, raspberry, and egg, and avocado toast. This is my favorite breakfast.
So I let my breakfast digest a little bit, hung out with Ruby, and fucking looked at the wrong one. It's fucking, it's about 12 o'clock right now, and me and Dallas are gonna go stretch, hit our cardio, and I like doing a little bit of like my ab work on my rest days. So I have two rest days a week, and I'll train core pretty aggressively during those time periods. I might train core like another day throughout the week if I'm feeling the energy to do so, but like I like getting a lot of that work in on my rest days, so that's something you could do too. But yeah, we're gonna go hit cardio, stretch, core, come back, and then I'll eat my second real meal. Usually what I'd have before I go to the gym is, so like I'd eat my first meal, I'd eat my second meal, and then I have a protein bar and generally two Rice Krispie treats before I go and hit the gym. That's like my meal plan for right now. But for today, since we're just doing cardio, abs, and stretching, I wanted to feel a little bit lighter. So I just had breakfast. I'm gonna smack my little protein bar. I'm not eating an Anabar right now because Anabars are a little higher in calories, boys. So like they're really good for if you're bulking and trying to put on weight, but not so much if you're trying to cut. I just got one of the generic ass pure protein bars. You can get those literally anywhere. But my favorite bar, like go-to, like basic bar you can get is the ones from Costco, the Kirkland Signature ones. Those ones smack. And you could throw them in the microwave, heat them up, and they're a chewy little treat. But yeah, so protein bar, one Rice Krispie treat. I'm gonna take a little bit of Gorilla Mode energy just to get a little bit of caffeine in before we go and do our cardio.
The Black Friday is going on right now for Gorilla Mind and for YoungLA. YoungLA, I've been talking about this forever, the 23rd. Literally, when I put this video out, YoungLA's Black Friday sale is going to be going on 30% off an entire week. Code BIGDAWG. I think they're dropping like 21 new fucking styles. It's going to be crazy. So, Gorilla Mind's having a huge Black Friday sale. YoungLA's having a Black Friday sale all week, 30% off with my code BIGDAWG. The Gorilla Mind one's a little tricky though, because they have like special deals that they're running all week, and then I think like this weekend, don't quote me on it, but my code's gonna be 30% off for Gorilla Mind. So you can get like, that's a lot, because usually my code's only 10% off. So definitely keep an eye on that. I'll put in the bottom of the video the dates that my code will be 30% off for Gorilla Mind and YoungLA. But regardless, boys, run that shit up. Let's go get this cardio. Maybe every once in a while on a blue moon if you just want to go have fun and get a workout in with the boys, but definitely try and take advantage and optimize your recovery time, because that's what's gonna give you that like next level physique in the end. I just know, like, I don't know, I can tell when I'm slacking on recovery. Like, you never feel right, in my opinion, so just take it seriously, boys. Okay, so that's like portion one of like my rest day recovery routine. Just get in there, cardio, stretch, do a little bit of core work. I'm about to go vibe, make some food, get ready for my second meal, and then later on tonight we're gonna come back, hit the sauna, stretch out a little bit more, and call it a day.
You gotta shake it up good. Okay, that's enough.
All right, so meal number two, boys. Just chicken thighs. I did 6.5 ounces a day. 7 ounces of cut up potatoes thrown in the air fryer with just like some Johnny seasoning and some garlic powder. These are gas every single time. I threw a half an avocado on that, and then I gotta get my greens in, so we just steamed some broccoli. And that's like what my lunch is looking like 9 times out of 10 right now, unless I'm having a cheat meal. It's gas. I still have a lot of calories to work with for dinner as well, so about to grub down. And then we got some other stuff that we're gonna do later this evening for recovery purposes.
What is this man's doing?
So after lunch, usually if it wasn't a rest day, this would be like my post workout meal. It's just two scoops of whey protein, whatever you want. I'm using Gorilla Modes, and 16 ounces of like the lowest possible unsweetened almond milk. And this is what I'm gonna have before I have my last real meal of the day, which is dinner. After I smack this, me and Dallas are gonna go back to the gym and we're gonna go kick it in the sauna for like 10 or 15 minutes. If you have access to a sauna on your rest days, boys, fucking game changer. We're at all, like me and Dallas go there almost every single day. It's the truth.
It's the truth.
So we're gonna do that, loosen up, relax a little bit. We'll come back, make our last meal, and then I'll probably say goodbye to you guys for this week. Maybe, probably. Dallas didn't want to check. We're going to the pool first though, because literally every single time we go up there's zero towels and it's freezing. No one told me it was this cold in Vegas in the wintertime. Just kidding, bro. It's nothing compared to Washington. Little fun fact for you guys, like, I like Vegas a lot. I wanted to live somewhere warmer for like just a little bit, but bro, honestly, I miss Washington. That place is such a vibe. I'll be back there for sure. Like long term, I'm gonna live in Washington, but for now I'm killing it in Vegas.
This place is so like over the top nice, low-key. Like, look at that shit, bro.
Cliff Bar.
What's Dallas's overall? We still haven't decided that yet, bro.
Last I saw, it was a lot of controversy, but it was, all I saw was the first number, it was a 9.
A 9? We wasted a trip because they actually had towels.
Fuck!
No, this on us right now. The lighting in here is pretty sick. Looking unnecessarily big, but it's just the lens, boys. If you see it in real life, it's not like this. The lens is doing me justice. Bro, I can't wait to drop weight too.
That's another reason why I'm like really motivated to kind of drop weight right now is, bro, I just want to get cut. Drop weight, feel healthy, baby. That's my motto moving forward into 2022. Drop weight, feel healthy.
I should turn on quick.
Yeah, it is. You know that Ruby's birthday is on the New Year's Eve?
Really?
Yep.
Are we turning up for it? Damn.
It's open. Nah, I'm just kidding. Those days are over. So obviously we're not gonna take the camera in the steam room, but bro, look at this. This shit is so nice. Watch. So we're gonna go crank that for 15 minutes. So I like stretching out a little bit in there, come out here, do some vacuums, and then bam, wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. That's a successful rest day. Get some dinner. Get some dinner, and then maybe we'll set up the PC setup. No, I actually did go through and buy the PC. Literally, the only reason why I haven't set it up is because I'm waiting on the desk to get here. I didn't want to set it up before I got the desk, so the desk is coming tomorrow. And I really want to start streaming soon, but I'm not like the most knowledgeable person on how to set up a good stream. So if any of you cool ass motherfuckers know how to set up like a Twitch and like get a decent streaming setup, DM my Instagram and say, I got the knowledge. All right, well, let's go. Let's hit this song. That shit was so hot. Oh my God. I'm like red from it. Jesus. Feels good though.
Yeah.
Gotta work on my vacuums. My vacuums looking suck. Something I neglected. I didn't even know what vacuums were for like the first 3 years I was lifting. That's how like out of touch with lifting I was. I was like, you gotta do vacuums, but I've been working on them. I definitely need a lot of work, but not the worst thing in the world.
Mm-mm.
Ruby, that's my dinner, not yours. Go away. Get out of here. All right, this is the last meal of the day, the last real big meal of the day. I got 6 ounces of chicken made by Kat. And then we got a bunch of asparagus because it's low in cows. I don't even really track that, to be honest. It's not that deep for me. Like, if I get fat because of asparagus, like, fuck it. So be it. And then I also have one serving of pasta. Is it up here?
Yeah.
One small serving of pasta. And a half a scoop or a half a cup of pasta sauce, right?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. So this is pretty much what my meals are looking like. I showed you. Like, that's everything I eat throughout the day. Minus, I still have like 42 grams of carbs I can consume, or 42 grams of protein I can consume. And here, I gotta look it up, actually. So that's why you track, baby, MyFitnessPal, because you don't really ever know how much you're fucking eating unless you're tracking it. But I still have like 42 grams of protein and 94 grams of carbs. So I like leaving a little wiggle room in the evenings for when I get hungry. I'll have a couple rice cakes. I'll usually have like a cup of just the non-fat Greek yogurt, or a half a cup depending upon how much calories I have to play with. And I like throwing a little bit of protein in there with a little bit of blueberries and a tiny bit of water, and you mix it up. That shit smacks. That'll be something that I eat like an hour before I went to bed, so that my body could have that right before I get to go to sleep, so I don't go to bed too hungry. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. We got a little bit of shoulders in. I got to show you what I'm eating right now. And as it adjusts, I wanna kinda give you guys like an update like every 2 weeks or month or so. Cause I actually have plans to kinda change up my diet pretty drastically. Not drastically, but I just wanna, I feel like I can eat even cleaner than I am if I go out and do a little bit of research on the type of diet I wanna do. So that'll be videos in the future. I got some fun videos planned, but I appreciate you guys watching. For everyone who watched this far, thank you guys. Drop a like, drop a comment if you can. It helps me out way more than you know, and that's what you would do if you was P-Way, for real. Last thing before I go, okay? Gorilla Mind's gonna be running huge sales all week. I know I've been preaching this. A special deal every single day this week. So this video dropped, there's a deal right now. You could check it out. This weekend, Gorilla Mind's gonna be 30% off with my code. That's like unheard of, because my code's usually 10% off. And then YoungLA is having 30% off all week, starting literally today. It happened at 12 p.m. PST. So when this video comes out, that shit's running. Code BIGDAWG will get you 30% off YoungLA. I appreciate you guys. I love you guys. P-Way the only way.